But the Bible says that Paul shook the viper off his hand and he suffered no harm. Some of you, by the reason of tonight's anointing, you will suffer no harm in the hands of your enemies because of the reason of the blood, because of the reason of the anointing. And the Bible says that, however, they were expecting that he would swell up and sadly fall down dead. You see the expectation of the enemy around you. These people, these natives, even though they didn't know Paul, they were expecting Paul to fall down and die because they saw this viper around him and they knew the viper had bitten him. And they were expecting him to fall down, to swell, and to foam in his mouth, and to drop dead. And as I speak to you right now, there are some witches, there are some wizards, there are some warlocks, there are some ancestral spirits, there are some household wickedness, there are some agents of the enemy in your workplaces, there are some people in your life who are waiting patiently to see you drop dead, to fail in marriage, to fail in your workplace, to fail in your career, to fail in your education, to fail in life. They are watching you sadly. They are watching you patiently to see how your life will end, because they know that you are going nowhere, and they have concluded in their mind that you evil things will happen to you. But if God be for you, the Bible says that if God be for you, who can be against you? If God be for you, who can be against you? If God be for us, who can be against us? Tonight, I came to speak to you. I came to speak to the first that be, that whatever they have devised against you, it will not stand. Tonight, you will shake. You will shake every viper, every serpent into the fire, and you will suffer no harm, and you will not drop dead. You will not be cut short. Your destiny, you will not fail. Your purpose, their plan concerning your life will not come to pass. They were expecting Paul to fall dead, but the Bible says that Paul had suffered no harm. And this is the expectation of the enemy against our lives, some of us, by the end of this year. But by the reason of tonight's anointing, the Lord will show you mercy. The Lord Jesus will show you mercy, because you have run into the name of the Lord Jesus. For the name of the Lord is a strong tower. The righteous, the child of God will run into it, and they are saved. However, verse 6, Acts chapter 28, verse 6. However, they were expecting that he would swell up or suddenly fall down dead. But after they had looked for a long time, they saw no harm. No harm came to him. When they saw that no harm had come to him, they changed their mind and said he was a god. I tell you the truth. After they had expected and they were waiting for the downfall, they were expecting for Paul to fail, they were expecting for Paul to fall down dead, they expected and it never came to pass. And the Bible says that they changed their mind. Tonight, people are going to begin to change their mind at your workplace. People are going to change their mind concerning you at your workplace. They have been waiting to see you fired. They have been waiting to see your marriage break. They have been waiting to see you barren forever. They have been waiting to see you laid off. They have been waiting for you to quit the marriage. They have been waiting to see your children out of school. They have been waiting to see you sick and die because of terminal disease. But God will intervene. And the Bible says that they change their mind when nothing happened to Paul. Tonight, may your enemies change their mind. People devising evil change their mind. And the Bible says that, and they said Paul was a god. Now they began to be terrified about God. Tonight, your enemies will be afraid of you. And they will think that you probably have a witchcraft or another occultic power. But the power that you have is the power of the Holy Ghost. The ultimate power, which is above all powers, which allows you to trample over scorpions and over serpents. Tonight, the words that I speak to you, they are life and they are spirit. And they are about to transform your situation. And they are about to help you to overcome serpent demons in your life. The Bible says that they changed their mind. They changed their mind. This week, my wife started working this week. The first week she goes to work after taking a vacation. First phone call which came after vacation, she took the phone call. She was so nice and the lady was so mean. She called me back. I was as nice as I could be to this patient, but at the end of the day, they were mean to me and they said they are going to report me to their boss. And the next time, another person comes mean, and it's like that week, there was an attack on her job, and all of them will say, we'll report you to your supervisor. And she calls me and I say that it is an attack of the enemy against your job, because we are about to finish the year, so the devil just want to attack your job. But anytime you go through this, just whatever they say, just hide it under the blood, cover it under the blood. When they say I'm going to report you, say no, you just deal with them nicely, and just after that you just say, Lord, I cover this under the blood. So she was expecting the supervisor, the boss, to call her, and the boss called one of the days this week, and she was afraid taking the phone. What is he going to say? Because people are saying that they are going to report me. And when the boss called, the boss began to congratulate her and to commend her. No, I'm very thankful about what you are doing at the workplace. And she was surprised, not knowing that all the people who said I'm going to report, none of them reported. However, a stranger rather called and reported her and was giving a good report about how efficient and how hardworking she was working. You see, God allowed her enemies to change their mind. When people come against you, when God is for you, God will always defend you. It was the same week that people are saying, I'll report you. It's the very same week that others also called in and began to give good testimonies about her. Because I said that whenever they come against you, just cover yourself under the blood. Some of you are so terrified about your job security. Am I going to be laid off? Are they going to get me out of this place? You are so cautious and you are trying to do everything to please man. All you need to do is to please God. To please God and to give your job and to give it to Jesus and say, Lord God, I am doing my best. Cover me. Protect my job. Protect me. I cover this job, this business under the cover of the blood. God, you have my back. And all you need is for God to be your defense. It was the very same week that her manager also called and began to shower praises on her. Because God will always cause your enemies to change their mind, and he will set a table before you in the very presence of your enemies. So we are going to pray.